Every mirror you've ever bought has already been used. You can never truly break a mirror, just make more of them. Remember these facts, one of them will be useful later in the story.
What are you waiting for? Do it!
A little backstory, okay. After the whole race, car, drive off debacle, Mama Red and Papa Goalie came to the conclusion that I needed an after-school activity to try and lessen my power, my unlimited power, because they'd hoped it would get me less injured. They were wrong, painfully wrong. Mirrors, backstory. One summer afternoon, after a long days of gymnastics training, yes, I used to do gymnastics, my class of 12 was like question life. Tired after the training. Anyway, we still had to do push-ups plus the quote-unquote cool-down exercises, which had all of us bummed out, so our coach decided, let's use the pit for some salvation. Gymnastics was insane. What's the pit, I hear you ask? Well, it's an Olympic length, 5 meter deep pool that is filled with like 25 by 25 cube sponges that we'd use to flip into the void and for some that suspension ring thingy. I don't know what it's called. I did gymnastics, but I don't know what it's called.
You are made of stupid.
Coach issued a challenge. Coach Sparks issued a challenge. First one from our starting position, 7 meters from the pit. Swim to the far wall, touch the wall, swim back, and then high five coach gets to skip cool down exercises. We all take up our running positions.
Your pity for the weak.
We all start sprinting to the pit like our lives depended on it. I tore off to the front of the pack and chuck my body as far across the pit as humanly possible. Start swimming desperately for the wall. Go for it. Go for it. I slapped the wall so hard that the whole gym heard that I got there. And as I turned back to swim, to coach, I realize everybody is still going towards the wall I just hit. And oh boy, I feel a surge of energy envelop me. I'm not swimming to win. I'm swimming to prove a point that I'm the cream of the crop, brother. That I'm never in danger. I am the danger. Let my name be the one that strikes fear into the hearts of lesser men. I am not here to win. I am here to make sure everybody else loses. I surge past my classmates and supersonic dash to my coach and give him a thunderous high five. I win. I'm the best. We all train hard, but I always got more in the tank. Woo! So, yeah, after that, we wait for everybody to finish up. I get my champion's arm raised. The coach tells me to go wait by the mirrors while all the other losers do what losers do, to cool down exercises. All right. Anyway, when I get to the mirrors, one of the mats I just step on, that is like right next to a broken mirror, slides under the massive weight of my ego. The mat then hits the mirror, tips it over, and while I'm still investigating what I stepped on and almost tripped over, I look up and I notice and ask the all-important question, why is my reflection getting bigger? And then, whammo! I open my eyes to the world tinted crimson red. Warm sensation on half of my face. My forehead has been cut by the mirror. Not like, oh no, a little boo-boo. No, like, look at your index finger. Look at from your actual knuckle, your first phalange, and then the second phalange. Yeah, that distance right there, that's the cut on my forehead. I let out a banshee's death scream. And thank God for Coach Sparks, because that man sprung into action. Hero, lifted me onto his massive arms, dashed out of the facility into his personal car, mind you, I applaud him for that, and drove me to the nearest clinic. He manages to get me to stop crying and tells me to apply some pressure to stem the bleeding. This man is on another level. I don't know if this has happened before, but he knew exactly what to do. When we get to the clinic, Coach Parks leaps out of his car and dashes to the clinic reception. Now, I, for some stupid reason, I think the massive amount of blood loss, just sat in the car and waited for Coach's instructions. He calls me in, and then I sit on a table or something, I forget what. The doctor tells me, "All right, Rambo, prepare yourself." And I look at Coach, "Why did she call me Rambo? Where'd she get that needle? What's she gonna do? Why are you making that face?" Coach holds my head still. I don't get any painkillers or anything. Nope, nope, nope. This doctor, she says to me, "Hey kid, today's the day you become a man." And she takes the needle, pushes my forehead skin, pushes it together, and starts stitching away. And a couple of skull scraping stitches and manly tears later, I am home, red and dry. Coach gets a visit from my mom, I think. I don't know. After that, I was too traumatized to think. I heard what needle and skull sounds like. I did not go to gymnastics for a really long time in fear of reopening my stitches because of how responsible I was. And then after that, I just stopped going to gymnastics. There goes another dream. Did I want to be a gymnast? Nah, I didn't. It wasn't a dream. Anyway, that's about it. Yeah, that's a crazy story. That's the second set of stitches I got. The first one, none of you are getting that story, you bunch of weirdos. If you can already guess the context, it's fine, but you're not getting the full story. I'll see you guys the next time I feel like telling you a fun story. But until then, I'm out of here, Scoob. Later, skaters.
Ouch! I'm dying! Oh, I'm too young and beautiful to die! Here we go! Why now? I had so much to almost live for!